the Mellon Trucks House in Newport Optimizer and built from there. Now, this one's tricky. Here we need an expression, and it's an expression that needs to contain a block containing arbitrary statements. We need to produce a duplicate without a semicolon at the end. Now, because there are arbitrary statements in the middle, we need to use rewriting again. But we can't use the null statement trick, because we can't parse as a statement. This is a statement kind of thing. We need to use an expression. So we're in a bit of trouble here. We can't produce an expression that does exactly all wrong. But for the moment, never mind semantics. Can we parse this at all? And the answer is yes. What we do is we generate some kind of expression, and then we write, so the next thing coming up is a binary operator. And the thing on the other side of that, the operator, is another expression containing that block. So, for example, we can produce an empty string, an arrow operator, and a method call. Now, we can rewrite the beginning of the block to that very easily. And we've got a nice the paren at the end. The Perl class will now be expecting a paren at the end, which is all right, because that's what we're expecting. Except the Perl class will also accept a comma and more arguments there. So we need to inject a bit more code just to check that the syntax is what we want it to be. So here's the code. We've got a paren, and then we stuff in the block declaration and stuff in the arrow next. And then here we generate that empty string. Although we're not putting an empty string into the stuffing into the code, we're generating the object directly. And we see parse expression. That's the code that we call from the git block, and then here we're generating the empty string. It's just a normal empty string, and we generate a const of pointing at it. And it's perfectly normal empty string in every way except one. That one being that we have a pointer to it. We have a pointer that's just a guess being, which means we can recognize it later, which means we can do this. We hook the endosub of generation, we recognize a method call with our magic empty string, pull out the first argument of the method, throw away the rest of that arbitrary and just return the argument call. So now, we've rewritten to this, gimbal does its thing, checks that we've got the right syntax, and then our endosub checker recognizes that method call wrapper and throws it away, resulting in the do block that we wanted. So the overall result is this was how we could write combined class satisfying using scope escape. And now, after all of that work, we can now write it like this, which I'm sure you'll agree was worth the effort. So probably use this yourself. You do have to write access. You want to look at the Perl API, look at this new variable, the plugin chain, and look at the new parts of the letter interface. There are various functions there. This whole section of the Perl API, and the documented parts of the PL class that existed before, but were the plugin API. And of course, look at scope escape sugar. It's obviously planned. You can actually write the code, which I just showed. It's got four big strings and small, and some big comments explaining how they work. So I'll talk very quickly about future directions for this. We're hoping in 5.14 to expand the API a bit. Hopefully we're going to have a way to move back to parse an arbitrary expression or statement, so you won't need to go through such conditions. We should also have more low-level Lexa parts like parsing an identifier. It's a question of whether I get around to it, maybe 514 or 560. We also want to get away from having to write XS all the time. There ought to be a Well, scripted fiction is the one I worked on that actually uses this mechanism. But module for a Perl interface doesn't get it. And by the way, the format of the actual the top level plugin function was particularly nasty and